Yo, what's up guys? Welcome to a brand new video. So I just want to speak you through these trades that I took here. As you can see, the last 2 weeks I've really been on the markets, having that time to release any videos. But I was on the charts, I've been analyzing, I've been backtesting. Recent news, I started with the FTMO free trial challenge, so I'm currently busy with that. A few of these trades that are here, all of them basically, are trades that I took and entered in that account. So let me just start here with this P over here, which is EURUSD. This is on the 1 hour time frame, and then just want to speak it through. So this is a loss that I took on earlier the week. Today's Thursday, by the way. It's the 30th of December. So this is a loss that I took here. So you can see, obviously, let me just lock it in there. It's 10 pips stop loss. So I tried catching this on the 15 minute time frame, but what I basically looked at was the structure here. And if you look at this, obviously I saw that market's coming down, you have this correction phase push down again, and obviously I was looking for that next phase to continue, and then taking the short. You can obviously see here it's 1, 2, 3. But that didn't work out. Market took me out. And this is the current trade that I'm currently in now. So I'm in this trade now. I'm going down to the 15 minute time frame, because this is where you'll see it. You'll see it better. I'll explain it better. Because I analyzed this on the 15 minute time frame. I took the trade on the 15 minute, based on the 15 minute time frame. So what I looked at this rejection here. Obviously I have this area here. Let me just lock in this as well. And then I was waiting. I don't know what I was waiting for. I just forgot to enter the trade to go short. And obviously this was my target, as you can see here. So a couple of minutes later, when I came back, what I saw that the market already did this. And the market basically went to TP. Then I think the market was around this area here when I saw the trade. And I'm thinking, oh my word, I must have done it. But when I saw the market went back up, I was like, okay, no, something might actually go my way here. It doesn't mean because the market's going up that I must out. So what then happened was I drew a zone here at this area, and as you can see, I basically got tagged in there. So I'm currently in this cell here with two trades running with a 0.10 lot size. So as you can see, that the market is obviously on its way down now. And what I want to look at is just for the market to break this area. If the market comes to this area here, then I'm happy with taking profits on both trades. So that will be an area that I'll definitely look at. So that's the trade that I'm currently in. And then let's go on to the rest of the trades. This is a trade that I took in the week. Here you can see a lovely descending channel there. Very straightforward. Impulse goes up. As you can see, I was in the impulse. My first... So I had two targets, obviously target 1 year, target 2 year. So my first trade I was running here, and then my second trade was obviously running there because I took two trades. The first trade was a lot size of 5.00. So that was actually a mistake from my side, because I didn't see that's the lot size. But that's what I went in with. So I did take profit, which was here. You can basically see here, take profit was it in this area. So that's the first trade out of the way. Then the market came down, and then what I did was I set my second trade that this my secretary's target was this. I set the stop loss basically into profit. So I set the stop loss over here. You can basically see that week came here and then that week took me out. So that's basically the end of where my second trade went. So for this trade, I went for 1,500 something in US dollars, and then this one was about $30. Overall, in terms of the trade itself, I'm happy with the trade and how it's going. Like I said, I'm out of it now, so took profits from it, and then this basically similar to that trade over there. Can see that we have this descending channel here, but smaller than what the previous one was. But once again, I had two targets over here. First target was it, and then my second trade, once again, I was taken out on my second trade this area over here. So my second trade, I trailed the stop loss to this area here, and then I was tagged out. You can see the market came down a bit, corrected, and then it shot up. Yeah, so that's it. I don't want to go further into detail in terms of what's happening on the left side of the market, but that's basically just in terms of the bigger picture. And then we have AUD/JPY. Yeah, so I believe I discussed this trade over here. If I haven't, so what I looked at here was, let me just see, what was I looking at actually? I think I have to go on the 4 hour because I can't see. Okay, there you can see. So basically, I think this was the third or second touch on the daily time frame structure. So market was obviously coming down. You can see high lows, lower highs. And obviously what I was looking at here was that I knew the market would go up. And if you look left, you'll see that this was the take profit area that I was looking at over here. You can see that the market took me out and the market went up. So that's pretty much straightforward. Looking at this, this is also the trade that I put in. Obviously went out with the losses here, as you can see. So I'm trying to think what I had structure. I think I had structure around here, structure somewhere here. So this was a touch on a trend line, and that's why I opted for the sell, thinking that the market would go down. But if you look at what the market actually did, you see that, and impulse, there you have that. This here, you can see. And what I'm actually looking at here is, this is actually a nice sell that will be on the horizon. As you can see, I already forecasted. Let me just take this out of the way. You can see here, I already forecasted what my thoughts would be for the market to get to this area then down. So if I'm just gonna, if I'm gonna do anything, I'll probably do something like this. Look at that area there. Look how the market reacts. Obviously go down to the 15 minute time frame. Zoom in a bit just to see. Okay, that's what I'm looking at. And then I'll probably just do something like this. That's a 23. 30 pip stop loss. Let's see what the rest the reward would be. It won't actually be worth it, but if it had to be down here, then it's fine, because then it's a 1:3, so I can work with that. Being on the 15 minute time frame, I can actually squeeze the stop loss to something like that. Depending on what candlesticks I get, I can squeeze it to something like that, and then can either have it here, but obviously I would want to look at first targets that would be here. And then obviously if the market breaks that area, I can look at extending it to a year, possibly go in once again with two trades, first trade setting the take profit at this area, yeah? And then second trade having the take profit set at this area. So we'd look at something like that. So this is something possible, and then obviously if the market does give me rejection here, I know that the market can go up. And yeah, so that's possibly what I could look at. Let's just see what getting here. Yeah, definitely. So that's something that you can look at, because you can clearly see if you look at the structure, you have the one, the two, and then the third touch over there. So I think I might actually go with that trade over there. So that's something that could happen, that sell over there. But like I said, that's the trades. Yeah, so that's basically the trades that I took on this FTMO challenge so far. In terms of losses and wins, I have, I think, five or six losses. And mainly because, like I said, I entered the market with two trades. So I take two trades on 1p. So but the thing is, while I'm taking those trades, the stop loss isn't too large. So if I'm losing out, I'm losing like about $12 based on both P's combined, and individual it will be $6 on one trade, $6 on the other trade. But with the trades that he take profit, it's like the, like I said earlier, the one trade was $1,500 in US dollars, one trade was $16, one trade was $30, and another one I had of $111 today's trade. Actually, it was, which one was it? Oh, it was a quick one. That $111 trade, I didn't actually analyze it, but it's part of, it's a candlestick actually that I looked at. Let me just check. It's a candlestick, I think it's, let me see, it's on this page. It's this candlestick over here. So I actually saw it on the 15-minute time frame. I think it's this, just that. That's basically what I got involved with. And then the lot size for that was 3.00. So I made $111 from that. And then another trade I made that I exited now, I think I made $14. So, and then the losses is pretty small losses, $10, $6. Yeah, it's around there, $10, $6, $2, $6 that was out. So, in terms of risk reward, I'm really trying to manage these trades. As you can see here, 17 pips compared to this. Also, you can see this is a 1:3. So, I'm really looking to have the risk at a decent level and making sure that the trades that I do win, I win with a margin that's definitely a good amount of money. So guys, that's my update on this piece. I hope you enjoyed this video. Yeah, I'll give you guys a update on what's happening so far. I've really been feeling confident on the markets, seeing new things every time. So yeah guys, thanks, and I'm out.